What is going on, everybody? It is Treeb from Treeb Talks here. And before this video, I was gonna just hold some things back. I was gonna hold my personal feelings back. I was gonna say, all right, Treeb, it's Monday, the game's over, let's rationally talk about this game. This game is gonna be remembered for a long fucking time. For not the right reasons. This game, this last Sunday, yesterday, was the day the Jaguars blew up. The talent blew up. The team blew up. Yes, this team's been bad. This team's been bad for a long time. It hasn't really been a great football team for a long, long time. It hasn't been. We had the 2017 year. That's it. These guys, this talent, this team is done. It's done. It's in the shitter, completely gone. The morale is down. The team is down. And these Jacksonville Jaguars are not going to be the same for a long, long time. Well, I guess they will be the same because they're going to be shit. And they're always shit. So, this team is going to be garbage for a long time. And it's going to continue to be garbage probably forever. And it literally, sitting here and knowing now that Jalen Ramsey wants to get traded, it really makes me feel like this team is done. It just, this team chose Doug Marrone over Jalen Ramsey. That is just the simple facts. It was either you keep this coach that runs the ball with Leonard Fournette on a two-point conversion, a call that you had the biggest balls to do. I literally seen this and I was like, this is Doug Marrone trying to earn the respect of the locker room back. They said, you want to win? You want to go out there and get a victory? Let's win right now. Let's go for two. Gardner Minshew has the hot hand. What are we going to do? What are we going to do to go for two? We're going to hand the ball to fucking Leonard Fournette. Literally the biggest draft bust. In 2017-2018, Taven Bryan and Leonard Fournette are the biggest draft busts that the Jaguars have drafted in a since Gabbert, probably. Fournette had a great rookie season. Hurt all 2018. 2019 has proved he is not the running back we thought he was. We reached for Leonard Fournette. He was not the guy we thought he was. The whole draft class of running backs that year was super good. Super insane. Super talented. And we chose the worst fucking one. And we took the first running back. And we took the worst fucking one. That is embarrassing. This team is embarrassing. It is a mockery to the fans that you are this idiotic and you are this bad. Why am I a fan? I am so close. I was gonna intro the video, go over the position grades, and go over everything and talk about the Jags. But as of right now, it's just a big fucking rant. Right now, I just want to rip that flag off of my wall and just end it. And just end my fandom, dude. It's so annoying. Jalen Ramsey's your best player. Great teams don't trade their best players. You know what good teams do? Good teams fucking extend cornerstone players of their franchises. You extend Blake Bortles. You give Nick Foles, the most injury-prone, most average quarterback of all time, an $88 million contract. But you don't extend guys like Jalen Ramsey. You don't extend guys like Yannick Ngakoue. Is this even a team that has any aspirations of winning? Is this a team that has any aspirations of getting better, of being top-notch? We're in the AFC South. This right now is the year that we should be competing and we should be winning the AFC South with the talent level that these teams have. Houston's a good team. I will give Houston that. But the Jags went out there and with everything that went on, with the penalties, with the Doug Marrone and Jalen Ramsey fight, with all that, the Jags still hung in there. Yes, there's positives to be taken out of this game, but there are so much more negatives to be taken out of this game. A positive, for example, Gardner frickin' Minshew is good. He's good. He might just be our quarterback. Like, and that is so wild for me to say, and that makes me over the top happy. So happy. It makes me so happy to see Gardner Minshew play well. It makes me so happy to see Gardner Minshew make all these throws, win, and, you know, put us in situations to win football games. We haven't had a clutch quarterback like that since probably Brunell. And you can make an argument about Brunell not being the most clutch, but Gardner Minshew wants to go out there and win. He's poised. He's a great quarterback. And I think we found our guy in Gardner Minshew. I really do. I really do. That's one positive that can be taken out of this. He led the team in rushing yards, not the bum that we picked with the fourth overall pick in 2017. Gardner Minshew did. And Gardner Minshew is in no way, shape, or form a mobile quarterback, and he still led the Jags in rushing yards. And Bortles would do that with Fournette, too. He would lead in rushing yards, not Fournette, and Fournette would get 18, 19 carries. And another thing that just grinds my gears, it's like, you have other running backs on this roster. It's not just Fournette. Why is Fournette out there literally every single snap? Where's Raquel Armstead? Where is he at? Unheard of. This guy performed pretty well in the preseason. Give him some reps. Take Fournette off the field. He's not good enough to be a 15 down back. He's not a 15 carry back, a 30 carry back, a 20 carry back. That is not who Leonard Fournette is. It might have been who you thought he was, but it's not who he is. Leonard Fournette is not that player. I hate to tell you that, but he just simply isn't. And we have other running backs on the team. Why? Why? This team is so badly managed right now that, yes, the players are drama, right? Like, the players cause some drama. They're not the most disciplined. They're not the most, you know, calm group. They're really not. You know, they want to win. They want to go out there, play well, play good football, and win football games. That's what they want to do. And sometimes the emotion gets the best of them. But this front office is so bad. Shad Khan, what are you doing? We should be rebuilding from within inside the front office. Getting a new head coach, getting a new GM, getting a new owner, not a new owner, getting a new head coach and a new GM. We should be looking for that. But instead, you want to go out and trade the best football player this team's ever had, probably. I will say it. Jalen Ramsey has that potential to be better than guys like Maurice Jones-Drew, better than Jimmy Smith, better than Keenan McCardell. This guy is elite. He's an elite coverage corner. And you don't get that these days. Do you think that this team is going to want to play for you now? This front office blew up this team. I know Jalen's the one requesting a trade, but the reason he's requesting a trade is because of how poorly fucking managed this goddamn fucking football team is. It is so fucking embarrassing. It pisses me off. It pisses me off that we're not extending our guys and we're not playing good football. We're not making good calls. Like, anybody in their right state of mind, if you're going to go for two, if that's the call, anybody in the right state of mind knows that Gardner got us down there, drove us down there, had a fantastic drive, and I think it was like a 60, 70-yard drive. This six-round rookie's hot. He wants to win. Why not put the ball in his hands? Why not let him try and throw for the two-point conversion? Why not run some RPO shit? Why not have Gardner run it in for the touchdown? They're not going to suspect that. You know what they will suspect? A run right up the middle with Leonard Fournette, because that's all we fucking do. That is all we do. I'm tired of watching Jags games because I can literally sit there, sit back, and tell you every single play they're going to run before they run it. They will run it right up the middle on first down. They will run it right up the middle on second down. And they will throw to either the flats, the tight end, something like that, on third down, and punt. There were some times Gardner Minshew went out there, proved that he has, you know, it, and that he was able to throw the ball down the field on some good plays. That's not the fucking coaches. That is fucking Gardner Minshew going out there and making plays. It's embarrassing. It's embarrassing to even say I'm a fan of the Jacksonville Jaguars. It was embarrassing before because we were so bad. But at least when we were so bad, we just had bad players. We have great players on this team that we are just going to let walk. And we're just going to let go. And we're just going to say, see you later, Jalen Ramsey. The best corner that we've maybe ever had. I mean, Rasheen Mathis is great. But Jalen Ramsey, like, this is going to be a recap. This is going to be position grades. Players of the week. All that. I do want to give out players of the week, though. I do want to do that. Because the players deserve it. These coaching staff, the front office, they don't. They lost my respect. And literally, my will to watch Jaguar football has plummeted super, super hard. I don't even want to watch the Jags play anymore. If Jalen Ramsey is not on the field for the Jacksonville Jaguars, and you're just going to give that kind of talent away, I don't even want to watch. I don't even want to watch. What's the point? What is the point? Unless Gardner Minshew, you know, is the guy, and he ends up turning this franchise around and, you know, grabs it from the depths of hell and brings it all the way up. I will refuse to ever, if we do turn this season around, I refuse to ever credit Tom Coughlin or Doug Marrone. Refuse. I will only credit the players and their play on the field because it's been proven that these guys are simply idiotic, stupid, dumb, all of that. This front office can eat a dick from sign Tribe, sign the fans, because you are insulting us. You are insulting us, and you insult your players, okay? Jalen Ramsey, I understand he may have got mad because Doug Marrone didn't challenge that call. I get it. I mean, I get it. You know, Jalen thought it was a drop, but I didn't think it was a drop. You know, looking back at it, I get that. But damn it, Doug. Explain yourself or something. Like, say, I looked at the replay, he didn't drop it. You know, like, fucking calmly address your players. Be a reliable coach. You can't control these guys. This is why you didn't last in Buffalo. Because you cannot control a goddamn fucking locker room to save your entire fucking existence. I'm over it. I'm done. This game, even though it was close and we had opportunities to win and this defense played well and Gardner Minshew played well, this might be one of the worst games I've ever seen us play because of the because of what happened afterwards, basically. We lost Jalen Ramsey from this game. Miles Jack got ejected week one. Like, we are falling apart, dude. Bad. Badly. Badly falling apart. And for that reason, I can't do it with Doug Marrone, dude. I can't do it with this front office. It's pissing me off. It's irritating. I had to rant. Players of the week, though. I want to give offensive player of the week to Gardner Minshew because, again, you balled out. That's two offensive players of the week for Gardner Minshew. He's on pace to be offensive player of the year for the Jacksonville Jaguars from Tribe. Defensive player of the week, Jalen fucking Ramsey. Obviously. Obviously it's Jalen Ramsey. Did you see how well he covered DeAndre Hopkins? And you're gonna do him like that. And you're gonna trade him. And you're gonna do the fans like that. This hurts. This hurts. This is hard. This breaks my heart. Honestly. It really does. I was emotional after this game. I'm emotional now. I didn't think I was going to be emotional recording this video. I thought I was going to be able to be calm, do the recap, but I just got rolling and I'm pissed. I'm done. I am done with the Jacksonville Jaguars. We're not going to the playoffs. We're probably not going to win more than 5 games this year. And this season is already a complete and utter dumpster fucking fire. And that was my Jaguars versus Texans week number 2 recap. What'd you guys think? Leave your comments down below. Don't forget, links down below as well. You can like me on Facebook at Tribe Talks. Follow me on Twitter at Tribe Talks or follow me on Instagram at TreyVonPixley. Also, if you haven't yet, make sure you hit that subscribe button. We're really close to 1.1K. Click that notification bell so you get notified every single time I drop a new video. I drop new content on this channel 6 days a week. Ain't nobody outworking me. Them's just straight facts. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. And as always, you guys have a great rest of your day.